Hello and welcome to the EcoThings course. My name is Leopoldo Armesto and in this video we're going to introduce the course. So this is the outline of this presentation. We're going to first explain the pedagogical and technical aims and then describe which are the required previous knowledge in order to follow this course. And then we're going to focus on the contents on each unit of the course. So the course pursues different kind of aims, but we distinguish them between pedagogical and technical aims. From a pedagogical point of view, we try to develop what is known as the theory of social learning developed by Lev Vygotsky. And the idea is to explore the limits of the zone of proximal development. That's the space between what a learner can do without aid and what can't do, okay? And we are going to do that using an STEAM approach, a science, technology, engineering, arts, and math approach. So for that, we're going to implement some kind of, we're going to show that we have developed along this course some interactive groups with learners of the same age and learners of different age. And in the end, the idea is to prove that we're going to implement this kind of pedagogical technology can be implemented no matter what the socioeconomic status of the participants, because of one of our, some of our participants were students at risk of social exclusion. So, also, the project has some technical aims. The project or the course is about electronics, Arduino, and programming. So we're going to introduce some basic concepts of electronics, and particularly, we're going to describe how to use low-cost electronics based on a proposal for an intelligent house. We're going to learn how to program Arduino and ESP microcontrollers from scratch, using a set of exercises and explaining the basics of these electronics and programming. And at the end of the course, we're going to explain what is Internet of Things. We're going to introduce Internet of Things, and we're going to show how to implement an IoT project using this low-cost electronics for remotely controlling the intelligent house. So the course requires, of course, some previous knowledge, and the course is aimed to teachers of secondary school, maybe vocational courses as well. But even if you're not a teacher, if you're, let's say, an enthusiastic learner that you want to learn how to program the Arduino, how to code it, how to implement an IoT project and everything, of course, this course will be valid for you as well. But in general, these are the basic knowledge that we recommend in order to follow the course. You need to know a little bit about 3D design, because we're going to work with 3D models in order to manufacture the intelligent house. Also, some electronic engineering in order to understand how the circuits are created. And you need some programming knowledge. I put here C++ because we're going to develop all the exercises using a block programming tool. Okay, but this programming tool actually generates C code that it's the one that we use for Arduino, and that's why I put here C++. And also in general, you might need any DIY, let's say, following the DIY philosophy, do it yourself. Like any Arduino project, like many makers do. So these are the contents of the course. The course is divided into 5 units. The introduction unit is this one. Then we have a second unit about the electronics. A third unit about programming and basic concepts of programming. A fourth unit about how to program the intelligent house and work with the sensors and actuators of this house. And a fifth unit in which we're going to focus on IoT, Internet of Things, and particularly the Bluetooth control of the intelligent house. So in the first unit, we're going to talk about the project, the EcoThings project. And then we're going to talk about sustainable development goals within the EcoThings and the pedagogical approach that we are going to follow, or we have followed in this project. And we're going to present two case studies that have been implemented into different schools. One is for a primary school, Santiago Apostol, and the other one is a secondary school, which is the Tafen School. Then in the second unit, we are going to focus on the electronics. We're going to provide some basic general description about the electronics components that we're going to use. We're going to explain about microcontrollers, particularly used in IoT applications, and some recommended materials, hardware to use in order to implement the intelligent house. And then we're going to describe actually the materials that we need for the intelligent house, which is basically made of three essences: a living room, a bedroom, and a kitchen. And we will explain how to assemble everything. And in the third unit, we're going to talk about programming, basic programming. And for that, we use a software which is called Facilino. And for that, we are going to first introduce this software that can be programmed through a web page or through a PC app. And then we are going to implement or see some basic exercises that are general purpose, let's say, exercises in order to learn how to program with this software and the electronics. And then we're going to focus on the unit four, we're going to focus on the intelligent house and how to program and how to do very basic exercise, how to control the temperature of the living room, how to do with, let's say, energy saving policy, how to control the light of the bedroom, or to, let's say, isolate environmental sound of the bedroom, external sound of the bedroom, how to detect fire or smoke in the kitchen. This is the kind of exercises we're going to explain. Also, how to print or display data on a LCD display. And in the fifth unit, we're going to introduce the Internet of Things. And we're going to introduce as well how to develop apps with App Inventor and how to develop apps or Bluetooth apps indeed with App Inventor and Facilino. And then at the end of this unit, we're going to see three live demos on the three essences of our intelligent house, how to remotely control the electronics. So in this presentation, I have introduced the EcoThings course. Thank you very much, and I hope you can follow the next videos.